watched the movie and thought to yourself, what's this character's backstory? And it's never really explained, especially when the role is played by a character actor. Sure, most people don't know the actor's name, but they recognize the face. Every so often, a connection is made between two very different movies, be it through a character or the aforementioned character actor. I made one of those connections recently through a series of movies with one connection. Daniel Stern. Yeah, Marv from Home Alone. Did you ever wonder how he became a burglar to begin with? Something had to happen to add to his destructive downward spiral. Now, before I start, let me state that this is in chronological order, not according to the year the movie was made, but by the stage in the character's development. Okay, first off, he starts off as a loving father.
This is no joke, Dad! There was a real monster!
Really?
Honey, there's no such thing as monsters.
It ran in from the hall, grabbed my ankle, and slid under my bed!
Under the bed?
Uh-huh.
Under the bed?
Yeah. No, Dad, don't! Yuck.
No monsters.
Sick.
I guess all the dust bunnies scared him away.
Bunny?
No bunnies, no monsters. There is nothing under your bed. Now, why don't you just go to sleep?
Two sons, a new house in the suburbs, and he's constantly working at a job that he hates. The job, the commute to the city, and his home life starts to get to him. So he steps out and has an affair with a coworker.
You screwed this little girl in my father's store?
No!
Nick was in his car!
Oh, Jesus!
And I'm not a little girl, I'm 20.
Riddled with guilt, his wife finds out and they separate.
I hate you! I hate you more! If hate were people, I'd be China!
Let's bring out the cake.
To help clear his mind, he goes on vacation with some childhood friends.
It's nothing to be ashamed of. I had the same problem.
But didn't you feel stupid? I mean, didn't you feel inadequate?
Yeah, for a while, but then I overcame it. Can I explain it to you again? I mean, promise me you won't get upset.
Okay. It's not going to do any good.
Okay. If you want to watch one show, but record another show at the same time, the television set does not have to be on channel 3.
It does!
No, it
does! It does!
No, if you're watching, watch a recording, then it has to be on 3.
But the TV or the machine?
The TV.
You're saying I can record something I'm not even watching?
Yes, that's the point. You don't even need a TV to record.
How would I see it?
Well, to see it, you need a TV.
But shut up! Just shut up! He doesn't get it. He'll never get it. It's been 4 hours. The cows can tape something by now. Forget about it, please. How do you do the clock? Oh, you're dead. You are dead.
When he gets back, he learns that his sons are missing. When the sons are finally found, they mysteriously pop up in Malibu and talk about monsters.
Hello.
Mom, I've got Eric.
Oh, it's Brian.
It's Brian.
He's found Eric.
Are they all right?
Are you all right?
Yeah, we're fine.
Oh, they're all right.
Thank God. Hey, tell them I'm here.
Look, Dad's here.
Stay right where you are. I'm coming to you.
Where are they?
Where are you?
Malibu.
They're in Malibu.
Malibu?
Massachusetts?
Where the hell is that?
Where the hell is that?
California.
After the divorce and vicious custody battle, he's left living out of his car, drifting from town to town, taking odd jobs to finance himself. A courier job lands him in trouble, and he's forced to go off-grid to clear his name.
Got the right package to the right place at exactly the wrong time.
FBI, you're under arrest!
Now, to prove his innocence,
that was set up.
He's got to go where no delivery man has gone before.
If you see this man...
Excuse me, I'm looking for a place called Devil's Peak.
And he's gonna need a little help from a real bunch of troopers.
Scout Leader Erickson will answer the rest of your questions right around the campfire.
Scout Leader.
One, two,
three. We got a fugitive on the loose.
You want us to hike to Devil's Peak?
How tough could it be? It's this far.
Leading to a case of mistaken identity, which puts him in charge of a group of scouts. After he clears his name, he heads out once again. After living off the grid, he starts reading the Bible and becomes a street preacher. He returns back to New York, and after dealing with the scouts, he remembered what his son said. Armed with the Lord and his new sense of discovery, he searches the sewers for monsters, hoping to turn his discovery into a quick buck. Adventure turns into a nightmare when it's discovered that there are in fact sewer monsters. The ordeal leaves him traumatized, and he would have become chub lunch if not for a highly intelligent homeless man who saved his life. Forever indebted to his savior, they leave New York in search of more lucrative gains, eventually winding up in Chicago under a newly formed identity of Marv.
We know that you're in there.
It's Santa Claus and it's Elf.
His story is now full cycle. Having suffered through life, we as an audience now know what Marv went through, and we're sympathetic to him, slightly. Now, try watching Home Alone after this connection. That's just my opinion.